Should I buy the Mi Mix 3? So a lot of people might not know who Jamé is or what the Mi Mix line is. The Mi Mix line is one of the first line of devices that gave us really thin bezels. Mi Mix 1, 2, and now 3. 3 has very little bezels and also no notch. That's the most important part. And that's something they started in 2018 when this device was announced and released. We finally got our hands on this device towards the end of the year, which is why I'm doing this video and asking that very important question, should I buy it? And it's a very interesting one because what Jamé brings to the table with Mi Mix is completely different from a lot of companies. They went with a slider. They went with a physical slider, not a mechanized slider. So you actually manually have to slide and unlock, and you can have different sliding sounds like this, but it unlocks your device and also opens up the front facing camera, which is hidden down there. And I like this whole idea of going back to something to solve a problem that necessarily you don't need, but everybody wants thinner bezels. Speaking of that, you've got much better real estate, which means when you're gaming, you've got a whole canvas to game with. There's no notch, there's nothing blocking your view, and you get to experience that to the highest level. When you're watching content, it's exactly the same thing. You get to experience it as much as possible, and I like that. Now, there's a fingerprint sensor at the back, which is really fast and effective. You've got a dual camera setup, which, it's okay. The camera's good, but the camera doesn't excel in low light situations. And I think when you think about what the price point of this device is, it kind of makes a lot of sense. You can pick it up on eBay for about $580 in the US, and it goes as a hand-to-hand competitor against the OnePlus 6T, I would say. And when you look at it in that perspective, this brings a lot to the table and can compete well. Now, the front-facing camera, most Chinese manufacturers will do the same thing, especially, you know, since I am black, I tend to look like I'm either bleaching or fading out, which is just not great. Guys, please fix that. Especially even when I turn up the beauty mode, it just doesn't work. That aspect needs to change. But I think in terms of full functionality on this device, it works really well. The other cool thing I found that is that it works on the Verizon network. So I actually have a Verizon SIM in here. And it works on that, even though it's basically GSM rated. So if you're looking to pick this up on Verizon, it makes a lot of sense. Now, it doesn't have a headphone jack, which I was kind of bummed out, especially if you're doing a slider, you have enough space to do that. But it does have some decent speakers on here. I think the overall feel of this device is solid, but not there. The OS is smooth and fast, running the EMUI latest version, but again, it feels very different from everything we use here, at least in the Western Hemisphere. Now, granted, those things can improve and it's easy to navigate the UI. I don't like the fact that it doesn't have an app tray, and I don't like the fact that it feels like a clone of, you know, what Apple's been doing with iOS. I like to see Android manufacturers go away from them and do their own thing. But that being said though, this device is solid to use. Now, battery life is something you're probably concerned about. It's been decent, it's been actually pretty good on this device, and I have to say that I think a lot of people will like that on the Mi Mix 3. Is this a device for you? I say for some people, yes. It doesn't have major flaws for me to say don't buy it, and it doesn't have super great benefits for me to say this is a, you know, once in a lifetime buy. What you do have is a device that has taken that approach of no bezels and done it well, even though, you know, you've got a slider, it feels really solid to use in your hands. And I think this is a start of something much better from Jamé this year. So we have to wait and see. But I think if you're looking for something different to show your friends, I think this is a device that you can definitely pick up, especially at a price point that doesn't break your wallet. And for me, that's something I think you should buy. So if you have any questions or any comments, let us know. Don't forget to like and share this video. Favorite this video, subscribe to the channel, and always enjoy your entertainment.